वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर ऑफ एनालॉग एंड डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन फॉर फोर्थ सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम, नीड ऑफ मॉड्यूलेशन एंड सम बेसिक्स एंड इम्पोर्टेंट मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक्स, एम्पलीट्यूड शिफ्ट की, फ्रीक्वेंसी शिफ्ट की एंड फेज शिफ्ट की. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज कम्युनिकेशन? सो कम्युनिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांसमिटिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम सोर्स टू डेस्टिनेशन और सोर्स टू रिसीवर. सो हियर इंफॉर्मेशन इज इंपॉर्टेंट. If the information is analog, then the communication is known as analog communication. And if the information is digital, then the communication is known as digital communication. So here we will discuss about the digital communication technique. So this is the basic block diagram of digital communication system, that the how the information is transmitted in digital communication system. So here first block is the source. So source is the generating the information, that is a human being, for the voice and speech is the information, a computer system, that is any device or anything which is generating the information is called source. Then the source encoder. In source coding, we decrease the number of redundant bits of information. That is, we decrease the number of redundant bit of information to reduce the bandwidth. So now, how can we decide that what is the redundant information? So answer is that the probability of that message of information. So if the probability of occurrence of any message is more, then the that message have least information or less information. And if the probability is less for any event, that is, it has the more information. So in source encoding, we reduce the redundant bit to reduce the bandwidth. Next is the channel encoder. In channel encoder, we add some extra bit, that is called parity bit. That is, in channel encoding, we add extra bit to protect the information from the error. That is why we add these extra bits, to protect the information from the error or to apply the error correcting capability. So in source encoder, we reduce the redundant bit in order to decrease the bandwidth. In channel encoder, we add some extra bit to protect the information from the error. The next is modulator. Modulator is the basic process where we add some carrier in the message signal. That is, in modulator, you combine the carrier and a high frequency carrier signal with the information signal. Then next is the channel. So about these four blocks, source, channel encoder, source encoder, modulator are the part of transmitter. Then the channel. Channel is the medium through which information is transmitted. This can be wired or wireless depending on the types of application. Then below is the receiver part. Receiver is the opposite process of the transmitter, that is the demodulator, channel decoder, source decoder and receiver. So in channel decoder, we remove the bits which are added at the channel encoder, and in source decoder, we add the bits which are removed at the source encoder, and then the receiver and destination. So this is sort of the complete processing that how the digital modulation process, how the digital communication takes place. Next is the modulation. The basic definition of modulation is that modulation is the process where some characteristics of the carrier wave vary according to the instantaneous value or instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal. So carrier is the high frequency signal and it is modulated by the low frequency signal. That is the modulating signal. Then why we need modulation? We need modulation to reduce the practical height of the antenna. Practically, the height of the antenna, it may be the lambda by 4 or lambda by 2, depending on the impedance matching. So that is the height of the antenna is inversely proportional to the frequency. So if we transmit the high frequency signal, we need low height of antenna. But if we transmit a low frequency signal, we need a higher height of practical antenna. In some extent, which is not possible. Also, at higher frequency, there is no low interference, low noise. Also, it may be used for long distance communication because of low noise, and it is also suitable for multiplexing. That's why we perform the modulation before the transmission of the signal on the channel. Also, the digital modulation techniques have some advantage over the analog modulation technique. Digital communication have the advantage above the analog communication. These are the flexible, its security is higher. We can easily apply the error correcting capability, error detection technique, also low bandwidth. So we prefer the digital communication. And for digital communication, we use digital modulation techniques, and mostly used digital modulation techniques are ASK, FSK and PSK. These are the basic digital modulation technique. In ASK, the amplitude of carrier change according to binary signal. Here modulating signal is the digital, which is encoded by the binary encoder. That is in the form of 1 and 0. So in ASK, the amplitude of carrier shift according to binary 1 and 0. So ASK is represented by the variation of amplitude of signal. For binary signal 1, the output of ASK is same as the carrier signal, but for binary 0, it has no carrier signal, that is 0 amplitude. It is clearly shown in the waveform. First is the input signal, that is the modulating or binary signal 1010. It is represented by unipolar waveform. Then the carrier signal. Carrier is the sinusoidal signal, which is the high frequency signal. And then the ASK signal. So from it, we can observe that for the input signal 1, the carrier ASK output is same as carrier signal. But for 0, it is the 0 signal. That is, in the ASK, the output is the variation of amplitude according to binary 1 and 0. In FSK, frequency of the carrier shift according to binary 1 and 0. So in FSK, the frequency of output signal will be either high or low depending upon the input signal. That is, if the input is 1, then frequency of the carrier will be high. And if the input is 0, then the frequency of the carrier shift toward the lower value. So it can also observe from the waveform that for the input signal 1, the output of the FSK and BPSK, that is the binary phase shift key, for 1, the frequency is high, that is cycle are close to each other, and for 0, time period is higher, that is frequency low. For 1, frequency is high, for 0, frequency is low. That is, the signal is in the variation of frequency. For binary 1, frequency high, for 0, frequency is low. In PSK, the phase shift according to binary 1 and 0. That is, whenever a signal shift from 1 to 0, 0 to 1, there is the phase shift of 180 degree or phase reversal. So we can observe from the waveform that when signal shift from binary 1 to 0 or 0 to 1, there is the shift in the carrier signal. There is the shift in the phase of the carrier signal. That is, phase of the carrier shift from the 180 degree. That is, it is reversed. The phase of the carrier is reversed. So in PSK, the phase of the carrier changed by 180 degree when the modulating signal changed from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1.